wrestle and have the pleasure of having USA's 2008 Olympic Games bronze medalist Corey Cogdell here with us today. Welcome, Corey, and thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
We've been talking beforehand, and you said you've been very, very busy after the games. You had tied for ninth during the qualifications. How are you feeling there? What was it like to be there?
Well, you know, attending my second Olympic Games was obviously an amazing experience. I think any time you get to go to the Olympic Games, it's not just about yourself, it's about your country as a whole and your team as a whole. So, you know, being able to go there and root my teammates on and just really experience that all again was amazing.
And you've been very, very busy since then, huh?
I have. I've been doing a lot of traveling, doing some coaching, had a lot of appearance requests and interviews. So training has been a little bit scarce coming into this match, but, you know, always fun to make it to World Cup Finals.
That's great. That's really great. And it is nice here, I'll tell you. We're having a great day. Tell us about the wind a little bit today during qualifications. Was it difficult?
The wind definitely played a little bit with the targets today, kind of gusting on and off. It was pretty calm this morning, and then my second and third rounds, I could definitely see it playing with the targets. And actually, you can't really see it from where we're sitting, but on the field, there's actually a little dip in some of the fields. And so kind of as the target hits that dip, you can see kind of the wind change and kind of start to play with the targets.
And what about the background here? Do you like it? Is it hard to follow the targets, or does it seem to be quite consistent?
Well, the background here is gorgeous. You know, unfortunately, I didn't shoot well today, but it is hard to believe that you could actually miss here. You know, green background, green trees, beautiful green grass. So it's about all you could really ask for good quality shooting. So you can obviously see from some of the scores that they're very high.
Yes, they are.
Welcome you to the shooting center.
What we're going to find here today is that we're going to have two Italians that are in the final, and they've been shooting very, very well. And we'll talk a little bit more about you know, Jessica Rossi when we have a chance to introduce her. But Julia also did a fantastic job to get today's final.
She did. Targets, representing Italy, winner on the World Cup final in Belgrade 2007, Julia Iannotti.
Then in fifth place, coming with 67 targets, representing the United States of America, we have Kylie Browning. She's 20 years old. She won the bronze medal in London in 2012. Now, this is kind of a new face for us.
Kylie is fairly new to the international finals, but she's actually been to about 7 or 8 different World Cups as a junior and in the Open as well, and definitely a great up-and-coming shooter.
Excellent. Then in fourth place, coming with 70 targets representing Germany. We have Jana Beckmann. She placed fourth in 2012 this year in Tucson, starting off the season. She also placed fifth in Lonato in 2010. In third place, with 71 targets representing Italy, we have Jessica Rossi. She has just won the gold medal in London, and boy, she did a banner job. She set a new world record, Olympic record, world record junior, final world record, and a final Olympic record. So you really can't do much better than that.
No, you can't. Only one target better.
In second place, coming with 72 targets, representing Finland, we have Satu Makela-Nummela. She won the gold medal during the Olympic Games in 2008, and she just missed entering into the final in London. She came in seventh. Then in first place, with 73 targets representing Slovakia, we have Zuzana Stefančíková. She's 28 years old. She won the silver medal in London this year, and she also won it in Beijing in 2008. She has won the World Cup final gold medalist right here on this shooting range back in 2004, and she does have quite a laundry list of awards that she has. Now let's just talk a second or two about Jessica Rossi, just coming off winning that gold medal at the games and breaking all those records. She's only 20 years old. I mean, what type of pressure do you suppose she's feeling?
You know, I think she's probably feeling some pressure, but nothing compared to what she dealt with at the Olympics. So I think that she's proven that she can perform very well under that kind of pressure, and maybe she even thrives off of it. So I'm excited to see what she'll do in the final here. I saw her compete in London, obviously, and watched the final, and it was one of the finest displays of shooting talent that I've ever seen. You know, when she shoots, she just looks very effortless, in control, and very calm. So, you know, I think, I think she became a junior or a open world champion on this range when she was 17. So, you know, to be a world champion at 17, I think that, you know, lines you right up to be an Olympic champion at 20.
I do believe that her life really does consist about shooting. We had a conversation, I think it was last year, and it sounds like that's exactly what she has. I don't think she's studying. I think it's just shooting, and obviously that's really paying off.
Yes, it definitely appears that pays off. I think at this level, it's very hard to do other things other than just focus on shooting and you know, get to this level.
There she is, Jessica Rossi. You know, it's amazing to see the talent that is in today's final. Some very young shooters, but with a boatload of talent, to some of the older shooters as well. And I think we're going to see this happening. There's Stefakova, first target getting away from her there. You know, just winning the silver at the Olympic Games. Probably that miss isn't really going to upset her too much. She does have a way of sometimes starting off a little bit on shaky ground and then getting right back into the zone, and she can pull it off somehow, you know?
Yeah, I think that sometimes when you start off a little bit rough, whether because you're nervous or you're a little too relaxed, both can be bad. You know, as you get into the final, you really realize that you don't want to just give up. You've made it this far, and that really pushes you to focus more and to really pull it through in the end. And I've witnessed the same thing with Susanna, that she's definitely a good closer.
Yeah, she really is. We have seen that in the past, that she sometimes gets off a little bit of a rough start, and then once she gets back into it, she just goes with it. Now, we just had three misses in a row, and do you kind of find that can be a little bit contagious?
I think it can be contagious, especially when you're getting, you know, two or three or four or five, and then it rolls around to your turn, and you're thinking, okay, why did they miss? And, you know, I always feel like I want to be the one to break that miss spell. And, you know, I think most of the time, if you think like that, you won't be the next miss.
That's good. Good news. And that's another miss, a second miss in a row there for Stefakova.
One of the other things that I notice sometimes about Susanna is that when she's shooting really well, getting those high scores, sometimes she does have a number of second barrels. So, you know, with it changing our game, going from two barrels to one barrel, I think sometimes if you're having a good day where you're not having to rely on those second barrels or vice versa, that can really determine how you do in the final.
So let's just talk about that just for a second. You're saying double barrel or single. We're talking about qualifications. And so why don't you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, shooting myself and watching other shooters, sometimes you'll shoot a great score, but your second barrel percentage can be fairly high. So, you know, if that's the case on a day that you shot really well, sometimes that can kind of play in the back of your head, knowing that you don't have that second barrel to kind of rely on going into the final. So, you know, I didn't see Susanna shoot today, so I don't know if that's the case. But I know, for example, in the Olympics, I shot right next to her in Beijing, and you know, she had quite a few second barrels, and I thought, oh man, for sure she's not going to shoot a good final. Well, she kicked my butt. So you can't always rely on that. But I think she'll get her concentration together here and get back in it.
Here we had Beckmann, now on to Rossi.
And of course, Jessica's just smacking them as always. So
she has such a look in her eye. Yeah. You know, when we are fortunate to have these cameras that are looking right at the shooters to take a look at what they're looking like, and you can see so many different. That's my third miss.
And she's just shooting right behind most of those targets. You can see her. She's almost just stopping her gun just a little bit as she pulls the trigger. So, you know, maybe a little bit of nerves playing into that as she's coming into this final in first place.
Again, now to Iannotti. It's a miss there. Now, in your opinion, is it normal to see so many misses on the first few targets? Or do you think it's just nerves that is playing a part here?
I think it is normal to see some misses in the first few targets. I think, you know, you've just come off of shooting, like we talked about before, double barrel rounds, and you're kind of making that adjustment. And if you haven't been practicing a lot of single barrels in practice, you know, maybe that's something you're thinking about as well.
Another great shot by Rossi. Makela-Nummela, who has moved up into first place, overtaking Stefanchikova. There we go. Stefanchikova hitting that target. And now let's see what happens. She could just
it always feels good to hit your first one. Once you hit your first one, you can definitely get on a roll after that.
Well, you know, oftentimes we see that, like, the last five targets is when the pressure really gets on and things start to happen and the scoreboard changes. And so maybe this way for Stefanchikova works for her, that she gets it out of her system at the beginning, and then at the end, while, you know, other people may be a little bit more nervous, then she just puts the pressure on.
Yeah, that's a great way to look at it. You know, there's one thing I've learned is that you can never count anyone out. Many finals have, you know, changed a lot in the last five targets, just like you said. So,
now take a look at her. Rossi there, she does. I mean, she looks like a panther almost, doesn't she? I mean, she just she has this little move that she makes. It's a first miss for Rossi, but it's consistent.
Yeah,
just
she
like you,
she
you're
looks
very consistent.
She looks very focused.
Yeah. Again, on to Stefanchikova with a hit. So we've got Makela-Nummela and 77 targets. She's got a two-target advantage now over Beckmann and Rossi, who are tied up with 75. Iannotti with a hit. Browning also is just doing a banner job here. And I'm not going to say that ever again.
You jinxed her.
You know, this is what happens. I should just have learned by now just to keep my mouth closed.
Never fail.
It's
talk
true.
About
it really
how
doesn't.
Good someone's shooting and they'll miss the next target.
Now that Beckmann has already shot, I can say, you know, she's shooting a perfect final up until now. And she's 29 years old. She looks a whole lot younger on camera.
She
you know,
does. I've seen her on
that.
The circuit for quite a few years now, and I always thought, oh, she's, you know, close to my age. I'm 26, so, you know, she definitely looks a lot younger, which will serve her really good in her 40s and 50s.
Just a complete concentration and seriousness on Rossi's face here. And another one has gotten away.
And that's actually really surprising. I'm surprised that she's missed this many early on, but you never know. Maybe she's going to go ahead and run them out. Wouldn't surprise me at all.
Hey. Makela-Nummela shooting a perfect score so far. 6 out of 6, and back on now to Stefanchikova.
Satu is very, very focused today. I shot with her this afternoon on my squad, and she was actually shooting right before me, and she was just, you know, very few second barrels, just really on the targets today and focusing hard. So I think, you know, finishing just out of those finals at the games has really pushed her to focus on this match.
That must be a very hard position to be in, you know, finishing in seventh and something as big as the Olympic Games, because you must just must go over and over and over in your mind after, you know, so probably a position, obviously, a position nobody wants to be in.
No, it's not a fun position to be in. You know, I had, I didn't finish in seventh, but I was tied for ninth, and I was just two targets out of the final, and it's a tough position to be in. You work for 4 years for one event to shoot 75 targets on one day. You know, I don't think that there's anything someone can do to prepare fully for the Olympics. It's whoever's day it decides to be.
Right.
And, you know, obviously it was definitely Jessica's day with an amazing performance. But yeah, hard to finish right outside of the finals, no doubt.
I'm sure that it is. And there must be a lot of what ifs. And if I had done this or if I hadn't done that or, you know, browbeating that, I'm sure that a lot of any type of athlete does.
Definitely.
You know?
And when you're talking about, you know, one or two targets, there's so many that you can look back on and just say, you know, what if I had hit that one or if I had taken that extra second to make sure I was really ready.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, in the end, you just have to be, you know, happy with how you did and try and learn from that experience.
Back on now to Beckmann. Shooting just really fantastically. Back on now to Rossi.
Hey.
Makela-Nummela making it look extremely easy, huh?
She is. She's making it look easy today.
And there is another miss there for Svechkova. Take a look now at the standings and see what's going on. Makela-Nummela with an 80 target. She has 80 targets, excuse me. An 80 target lead.
I know, you're trying not to say that.
2 target lead and in first place and just shooting really like a star. I mean, if she can just keep doing this, she will be the 2012 World Cup final gold medalist, but we're really too early into this competition to actually say where we're going to end up here.
Better knock on some wood real quick.
Right. Now, Browning, she's also, like Rossi, is 20 years old.
She is.
Do you know when she started shooting?
She started shooting when she was 9, I believe. She started shooting sporting clays and then has been shooting international trap for about the last 6 years. So actually, almost surprisingly, as long as I have. but she got a little bit earlier start to it than I did. So she actually was our Olympic alternate for the USA team. And her and I really battled it out during the Olympic selection. So it's great to see her making the World Cup final. And, you know, maybe getting a little bit of that back.
Yeah, that's great. That's actually very good sportsmanship on too.
Well, you know, the really tough thing is that we only get one spot for the Olympics. You know,
right.
Women only get one spot. And even if you've got number 1 and 2 in the world, they both can't go if they're from the same country. So, you know, I'm definitely great friends with a lot of my teammates and want to see them do well.
Makela-Nummela now with a 3-target advantage over Beckmann, who has climbed up into second place. You know, she's both of these women shooting perfect finals as of the moment. And now back on to Janotti. No bird for Browning. And just basically hit that squarely.
That's always a good feeling after a broken target that kind of unsettles you a little bit to crush it like that.
Does it still unsettle you if you have to up against a no bird? Do you have a hard time getting back into it, or is it?
I wouldn't say I have a hard time getting back into it, but it definitely breaks your rhythm a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to make sure that you take the right steps to really reset your mind and reset your body and just refocus on hitting that target.
Well, you're certainly right. Satu is just shooting extremely well today. Sure that she is Over. Wanting that gold more than anything right now.
She is.
And that was just another no bird. That was for Svechkova. She's coming off of 2 misses right now. See if she can get back in this. And she can.
I'm definitely not counting her out yet.
No,
she's,
no.
You know, like we said before, a good closer, and she's definitely within striking distance.
She certainly is. And yeah, I would never ever say a thing about her actually until the very end. Now you're saying that Browning started when she was 9 years old. How old are you?
I'm 26.
But how old were you when you started shooting?
I was 19 when I started shooting the international sports.
No
so
kidding.
I was actually just 2 years out from the 08 Olympic Games. So yeah, I was started a little bit late in life.
Okay, wait a minute. Let's back up a second. You started 2 years before the 2008 Olympic Games and then won the bronze medal.
I did. Yeah, I started shooting American trap when I was in high school and then found out that shooting was an Olympic sport when I was 16, but there was nowhere for me to train. Coming from Alaska, the closest bunker was in Canada. So I waited till I graduated high school and moved to Texas and started pursuing my dream of making the Olympic team. So that was in the spring of 2006, just 2 years out from the Olympics.
Unbelievable. Yeah, so. That is really something else.
Yeah, when I get down on myself about, you know, having a bad match or whatever, I just have to remind myself, I've been doing this for 6 years and made 2 Olympic Games. It's pretty good, and I definitely feel like I have the best years of my shooting career ahead of me.
I definitely do, definitely. Svechnikova coming off of one miss there. So a 3-target advantage Makela-Nummela has over Beckmann, who's tied up with Rossi with 80 targets. And Svechnikova is in fourth place. And back on to Iannotti. You can see that the breeze has picked up just a little bit. It could be playing with these a little bit. There's a miss there for Browning.
Yeah, this is Kaylee's second international final. So, you know, the pressure of being in an international final is a lot different than, you know, shooting nationally or just shooting a match internationally. So, you know, she's a little bit young in the finals, but I've witnessed her shoot some phenomenal finals. So I definitely think, you know, in a year or two, she's going to be a heck of a threat.
Another one who makes it look quite easy now, doesn't she?
She does.
There's a first miss there from Makela-Nummela. She did have a 3-target advantage over the others. And Svechnikova getting back into the game.
And this is where it can really change up, is when you're straight and you miss your first one. Either you just take a deep breath and erase that, or you choose to dwell on it. And that's where you can see the final really change for someone that's shooting straight.
Also, Iannotti with a miss there. So you must have to do quite a lot of mental training as well then.
We do. I mean, I think, you know, anyone that gets to this level has to really have a strong mind. So whether that's working with a sports psychologist, really maybe just paying attention to your own body or reading books, I would bet all of these women have done some pretty extensive mental training.
I bet they have. You generally see it towards the end of the final, but now it's kind of happening in the middle.
It
here.
Is.
Yeah.
Oh, and
you were right
just
on
like
with
I
that.
Said, mm-hmm. You could see kind of see her body language after she missed the first one. She actually kind of stomped her foot a little bit and kind of threw the hull. And I was waiting to see what her next shot was going to present.
Makela-Nummela, well, now with only a 1-target advantage over Beckmann, and Rossi in third place with 81 targets. Iannotti with another miss.
And another broken target.
There's sometimes that it seems like there's one person that's haunted by them, you know?
That's very true. I've been that person before and watched that person in the final before, and it's so true. You could never get a broken target the whole time and get 5 in a final. It never fails.
And it looked like that kind of affected Browning there.
Yep.
Beckmann hitting that square on. She's really putting the pressure on Makela-Nummela at the moment. Back on now to Rossi, coming off of a miss with a hit.
Hey! And a solid hit.
Yeah, that was a very good one. Stefanova with a hit. One target advantage Makela-Nummela has over Beckmann. Rossi still in third place, and Stefanova in fourth. Browning coming off of that miss with a hit. She looks like she's getting right back into it. A little determination in her eyes there, as you can see.
She's a very, very determined girl. She's worked really hard the last couple years and has come up from, you know, consistently finishing fourth and fifth in the U.S. to being really consistently top three. So very determined and, you know, very young, and she's going to have a great career ahead of her.
And Makela-Nummela is still holding on to first place with that hit. I think that what we were saying before, she is determined to end up on the highest step of the podium after the Olympic Games. Svechikova now starting off a little bit in a hard place there, and it's kind of following her through, but we're not going to make any comments about that until the very end. And she's back into it. Scoreboard really has not changed at all. We have Browning and Iannotti with 77 targets, tied up for fifth place. Now you were saying, Corey, that your schedule has been just crazy since you've been back from the games. How many days a week are you getting in to train right now?
I'm really only getting in probably about 3 days a week, sometimes less. They're definitely very sporadic and kind of far between. You know, anytime the Olympic year rolls around, you're getting tons of media requests and appearances. And I've been trying to do a lot of coaching with local kids and everything. So it's been busy, but, you know, this is the time to kind of start slowing down, take a couple months off, and then, you know, get ready for World Cup season again.
Right, but you were saying also that you're still training quite a lot now for that for that reason by itself. And I think that must be really taxing on all of these athletes. You know, you're coming off the Olympic Games probably mentally and physically exhausted, and then you have to just put it back to your superpower to keep on going.
It is. It's extremely difficult to come off of, you know, some people, the biggest match of your life, and then be asked, you know, 3 weeks later to come to World Cup Finals. And for us, we're having a selection match in about 2 weeks after this. So, you know, it's very hard for the Olympic team to come back and be asked to, you know, go out there, train hard some more after you've just put everything you have into the Olympic Games and try and make, you know, your team and secure the spot for next year.
That's right. And that's, you know, never to mention that within that time you also do a couple overseas, you know, trips, and that takes a lot out of it itself.
It does. You know, traveling definitely takes the toll on your body, just the jet lag and having to recover from that and you know, being away from your friends and family and that kind of mental attacks of, you know, okay, I've got all these bills at home and this and that, and, you know, trying to keep everything organized. It's definitely tiring.
All right, let's take a look at Rossi now. She has experience in no bird.
Still shooting a very good final.
She certainly is.
Dropped three. And I didn't jinx her that time.
You can say what you want, but I'm keeping myself quiet.
Well, and clearly Satu's right back in it.
Yes, she is.
After those two misses.
Once again, nothing's really changing between the top three. Rossi's in third place, one target behind Beckmann, who is behind Makela-Nummela by a target. And there is a miss from Iannotti. You can see the wind is picking up a bit here.
Nice hit.
Mm-hmm. Beckmann is just shooting an amazing final. Only one miss throughout the whole thing. Really showing her talent. And I think we're going to see her face around a little bit more than we thought. Rossi there with a miss.
Hey.
Makela-Nummela. And again on to Svechnikova.
I think it's incredibly impressive that you've got two 2012 Olympic medalists making the final here, shooting incredibly well today. Mm-hmm. I can't imagine the kind of schedule that they've had the last 3 weeks, you know, celebrating appearances and all the media requests that they've had. So, you know, obviously they've either been able to, you know, fit in some good training or just came here incredibly determined.
That's right. Again, on to Browning.
Oh, another
see,
broken
she is.
Target.
She's completely...
Yeah, she's not the lucky one. The trap gods are not smiling on her today because she's getting a lot of broken targets.
And that did affect her. A miss there from Browning. On now to Beckham.
Shooting very consistently.
With that last miss, Rossi is now two targets behind second place. Makela-Nummela also with a miss there. This is going to make things a little bit more interesting. Svechnikova also with a miss.
Yeah, she's having a rough final.
Yep, she is, unfortunately. We've got now Beckmann and Makela-Nummela tied up for first place. Two targets behind, we've got Rossi. I think we're going to have to keep our eyes really focused on Beckmann here. You know, she has never made it to the podium. Did she just get another?
She did. Just got another broken target.
Unbelievable from Browning.
I think that makes five or six this round.
That's really too bad to have five or six no birds. You can see that's affecting our game.
Yeah. That's a hard thing to reset from when you've got that many and then you've missed, you know, considerably after each one of those broken targets. It's a really hard mental block sometimes to get over.
I would also think that you would almost think, okay, the next one's going to be a broken target,
yep.
You know?
Yeah, you're definitely wondering if it's going to come out and you can get that split second of hesitation that just puts you just a little bit behind the bird and...
All right, let's take a look here. Makela-Nummela has overtaken Beckmann after Beckmann lost that last target, and Rossi is one target behind. Back on now to Iannotti. Five birds to go. This is where we can see things change around a little bit.
Yes.
Okay. Browning has gotten it back into the game, and back on now to Beckmann.
At this point, you're just counting down. All right, one, four more to go, three more to go.
Does that go through your head?
Definitely.
It does.
Definitely.
Hey.
Svechnikova with a miss. So things have not really changed between the top three women here. Makela-Nummela is still in lead by one target advantage over Beckmann. Let's see now how this goes for Browning. Nice.
That's a tough target, too.
She's got a really nice follow-through also with that.
She does. She's very smooth.
Rossi smashing that to smithereens. Moving on now to Makela-Nummela. Yeah, she seems quite determined.
Yep. She's right in the center of them. I think, unfortunately for Susanna, it's a little too late.
Yep, I do too.
For that closing game we were hoping for.
I guess we can cut her some slack, though. I mean, yeah. She did just win the silver.
That's right. I'm sure she would have rather won that silver medal than win here, so.
Yeah, I'm absolutely sure of that, too. Again, on to Browning. That's too bad, a miss there. And now it's on to Beckmann to experience a no bird. And let's see if she can hold on to this. If not, this is going to change the scoreboard around a little bit. Let's just see if she can remain cool and composed.
The curse of the no bird.
Yes. Nice shot there by Rossi.
Hey. Solid hit.
Really great. Two more targets to go. And for Stefanova, one more. There we go. And she's got it. And let's just take a look now and see what's happened. And in fact, Beckmann is now tied up for second place with Rossi. It could come down to a shoot-off. You just never know how the last two targets are going to go. I have a feeling that Rossi's really going to just narrow right in there, with having a little bit more experience than Beckmann has. Off of a miss. Beckmann has got to pull this off, and she does.
Hey!
No bird.
Oh, no bird.
No bird. Okay, let's see if what's been happening before happens again. I have a feeling she's going to just nail this. Sure she can taste the gold right now.
I'm sure she can.
There she goes.
Yeah. And I think that might have tied it up for her.
I think so too. Let's take a look after Fetchikova. That was a miss for her. Yeah. Makela-Nummela has already won the gold medal. It's just down to the silver now between Beckmann and Rossi. We could be going into a shoot-off. We'll just have to see how the last shot goes. Last shot for Iannotti. With a hit. Beautiful way to finish off for Browning with a hit. On now to Beckmann. If she wants to keep in contention for the silver, it's got to be a hit.
Oh.
And it's a miss. Rossi can really take this as an opportunity. And I'm sure that this is exactly what she's going to do.
And she did.
And she has done it. I see they just turned around to see what's going on here, looking at her coach.
Hey.
Oh, and Satu missing her last one.
not the best way to finish off a final, but it does still secure her the gold medal. So. Let's take a look now and see if we can see our medalist today. There she is, gold medalist from Finland. Satu, Makela-Nummela, winning the gold medal by a target. Let's see here if we can see our silver medalists and bronze medalists. And there, once again, Satu Makela-Nummela finishing with a gold medal. Excellent work, 2012 World Cup final gold medalist. Corey, thank you so much for joining me today. It was really nice to catch up with you and to hear about the Olympics and everything. And I wish you a little bit of downtime so you can relax and then pick it back up there so we get to see you in March, okay?
Thank you, thanks for having me.
Track women final finals. Ladies and gentlemen, the medal ceremony for the final trap women will now take place. The medals will be presented by Mr. Luciano Rossi, the International Sports Shooting Federation Vice President. He is accompanied by Mr. Igor Rakusha, President of the Organizing Committee. The bronze medal goes to Jana Beckmann, Germany, with a total score of 91 targets. The silver medal goes to Jessica Rossi, Italy, with a total score of 92 targets. And the gold medal goes to Satu Makela-Nummela, Finland, with a total score of 93 targets. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Finland.